Alright, on a lighter note, I did go to the training camp for rookies and prospects at the Wilmington rink. It was open to the public, and I gotta say, there's a lot of people there. I'm gonna say probably 85% of them were pink hats. And, you know, they didn't really understand the whole process of, you know, development camp. But I saw a few good things. I actually got up close and personal with Dougie Hamilton, and the guy is a fucking giant. I mean, if there was no lockout, he would definitely crack the roster. I mean, I saw a slap shot. I saw how he was. He skated. He played. He was just nasty. There's no words for it. The guy is just nasty. You put him with, like, Chara. I don't think he'd get to that point, but you put him with a Chara, and, I mean, on a power play, I mean, Jesus Christ. They make goalies have nightmares. He just looked nasty. And I gotta honestly say, from a Bruins fan and to a prospect, that he was the only one that looked good out there. Everyone else was just, mediocre. You can't really tell right now, but no one else really had it. And that brings me to my next player was Knight. He's actually a small guy, and I know he came over in the Phil Kessel, you know, deal with the draft pick and whatnot, and, I mean, he's fast on his feet, he's good, but he's just not, like, the size, and, you know, you say size is not always the thing, skill. I mean, I didn't see much skill. I just saw he goes fast, he can shoot, he can make a play, but I think he's probably Providence-bound. He reminds me of a Zach Hamill. And I hate to say that, because Zach Hamill, you know, it's been shit. But still, you know, I give Knight his, you know, a lot of credit. I would like for him to be in the Bruins one day. You know, him and Spooner looked like they were connecting well. I didn't see much of Spooner, though. I just, you know, focused more on Knight and Dougie. Because, you know, it was time to Dougie. But, it was definitely a great experience to see those two. And I think, well, the real reason why I went was because I wanted to see Malcolm Subban, the Soupster. And now, if you see my other videos, you see how I called his brother a monkey. Now, you probably think I'm just a racist, I'm a piece of shit, blah, 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 blah. That's fine. But you know what? I respect the kid. Malcolm Subban, at least. Because he's on the Bruins. But I will honestly say that I do not think he'll ever suit up and be in the Bruins lineup. I don't think he'll ever even make it to the Bruins. I think he'll be traded before he even makes it to the NHL. He's got size. It's just, he doesn't, I don't know. I know he had a lot of ankle problems on the Bulls. But he just looked like he was out of place. I don't know, he's just a kid, and he has a lot of growing up to do, but it just didn't look right to me. I think even he was surprised to be drafted by the Bruins when it was, you know, draft day in Pittsburgh, because he had that face on, like, are you serious? But, you know, that's his personal problems and his personal demons, and, you know, I have nothing against him, and even though I hate his brother for the sole fact that he was a Canadian, so, you know, it has nothing to do with being black or being a monkey. I'm just messing with you. But seriously, though, development camp was pretty interesting to watch. I've never been to one. And when I went to one, there was just so many fucking people. There was nowhere to sit. And it was a good experience. I mean, you know, a true Bruins fan would go, but there's plenty of pink hats. A lot of little kids, a lot of little girls. Like they were going to fucking see Sagan or something. So, it was one of those things where you just had to be there. It was fun, though. But, I mean, I didn't see anybody that was too impressive. Except for Dougie Hamilton. The Dougster. Dougie! So, you know, time will tell. The lockout ends. Maybe we'll see Dougie Hamilton.